Namaskaram Sadhguru, I am RJ Navneeta from 104.9 FM Fanija Radio in Dallas. Thank you so much for agreeing to take a question from our listeners on our radio. And the question is by Bharti Sundaram and she asks, Sadhguru, what inspired you to do this tedious ride, traveling through the night and explore the American Indian culture and history? And due to the similarity of worshipping nature and other habits like Asian Indians do, is there genetic resemblance between the two? Thank you so much. And thank you from our CEO, Vaishali Thakkar of Fanija Radio.
Namaskaram, Navneeta. Well, the journey is not tedious. Why would it be tedious? Well, it's a bit adventurous and somewhat dangerous sometimes, but not tedious for sure. Something becomes tedious only when you suffer what you're doing. Here, we've been on the road for over a month now. Well, all the comforts of home are gone, but I think everybody here, the entire team, is now getting a little uppity that in another 4 days, this whole campaign will end. So, if it was tedious, they would be waiting when it'll be over. Right now, I see a little bit of terror on some faces that, oh, it's going to be over in 4 days kind of thing. So having said that, about Native American culture, the similarities, one similarity, one very strong similarity is about worshipping, worship of elements. In India, we always worship the five elements and we have systems, very sophisticated and complex systems, how to manage and master the five elements within our body and also around us. Here also there are such efforts, they're largely talking about four elements, leaving the Akash. So in that sense, it is very fundamentally it is so, but I don't think we should draw a parallel that it is like India. I think in any ancient society, till imposition of very dogmatic religious processes, almost in every part of the world, human beings naturally identified that the source of life is in the five elements. Some worship four elements because they left out the Akash, but in other places all the five elements. So that is not just a parallel between Native American culture and Indian culture, they're not because of any similarity or connection. In terms of genetics, are they connected to us? Well, I don't know, they're largely Mongoloid people. If you look at them, they look more like Tibetans. And of course, in India also, a certain segment or probably around 15%, if I'm right, 15 to 16% of the population is Mongoloid race, even in India. In that sense, yes, in the northeastern region, the people are connected, but I am not a genetic scientist or something, but to my untrained eye, they look a lot like Tibetan people or people from Mongolia and that region. But the Mongoloid people in India also could be of the same source. I am not the one to track this genealogy business, but well, people are people, it doesn't matter what is the shape of their eyes, nose or chin. The important thing is, in the heart of hearts, everybody has humanity. Will it flow in this life? Will people allow their humanity to overflow or will they mask it with some other identity? Will they mask it with fears? Will they mask it with prejudice? Will they mask it with jealousy and hatred? Or will they allow it to overflow? This is all the question is about human beings. What does it matter? What is the shape of the chin or nose or eyes or the color of the skin for that matter?